Or hi, I'm back. And so last time we did some outlining and we offset our lines. This time I'm just going to do this last little line, and because it's an individual line, I can't use my offset tool. Right, and so instead of trying to do that, what I could do actually is kind of do a little bit of a, we're just going to offset it by hand this time. So we're going to use the move tool, which is somewhere in here. Here we go. We're going to select that line, and then we're going to move it. Now you can see that this does weird things. Right, welcome to SketchUp. If you move something that has connected to other objects, it'll do this, right? But not if you hold down, or if you click on the or tap the control key, right? Which toggles the copy mode. So we move on to copy mode. Now I want to move in the red direction, and I want to move 0.1 meters. So I'm just going to type in 0.1, and there we go. Right, so now I can get rid of this little line segment here, and there we go. Right, so a few things, other things I need to delete. So there, and here. What we want is to create this into a completely closed loop. Like that. Now, I can now delete these interior sections, and now we're ready to extrude. Right, so let's have a look here. We want to go back into a 3D view, and it's easier if we're using a perspective view, so there we go. So there's our floor plan, there's our person. What we're going to do is we're going to select this surface by clicking on it, and now we're going to extrude it. And hopefully you've had a go at extruding things already. Here we go, we're using the push-pull tool, and we're just going to click once on the surface, and then again, we're just clicking once. You know, we can let go of our mouse now, and then when we get back to it, we can drag it up to the size that we want. So for the purposes of this example, we're going to make it 2.7 meters. So 2.7, type that in for the distance, and there we go. So there we have the walls for our building. Now you'll notice there's no windows yet, there's no doors yet, there's no way to get into this building, and it doesn't have a roof, but that's okay. We can start by just drawing on the elements that we want. So we want a front door. Let's see, say we put the front door here. We could, let's say, just draw a rectangle here. Now, in this one, you'll notice in the box down the side here, there are some dimensions. And as I move my cursor, the dimensions change. So I can change this to the actual dimension that I want. So for example, my door is going to be 0.8 meters wide. It's 0.8 meters wide. Then I'm going to type in a comma, and then I'm going to type the height. So that'll be 2 meters, let's say. So 0.8 comma 2, and there's my door. Right? Now to actually turn it into an actual door, an actual gap, we're just going to use the push-pull tool again, and we're just going to push this in like that until it says on the face. When I click there, it disappears, and now I've got a building with a door. Alright, I'm not going to go away. I'm going to put in some more windows, and then I'll show you how to kind of finish off the drawing by, or how to finish off the model by adding a roof and some other structures like that. Okay, thanks very much. See you in the next one.